Until 1978, the only dance group anyone knew was Pan's People. They were classy, they were sexy, in a way your mom would like. In 1978, they were history. There was a hot new act. They danced dirty, they dressed dirty, and they had your mom reaching for the remote.
Hot gossip. They were fantastic, weren't they? They were like Pan's People, but in the right outfits. Do you know what I mean? And you knew that they'd go. And you didn't have to marry them, and you didn't even have to get engaged to them. They were your sort of fantasy girls, you know.
Their routines just tended to be sliding up and down fireman's poles, didn't it, in dresses made of cling film.
When we started working in the nightclubs, we had no money.
I decided that lingerie was pretty cheap and I'd buy a few bras and panties and put them over the top to make them look different. And one of the boys in the group, Roy Gayle, was working part-time in a sex shop.
I've got a very good friend, and my best friend works in a sex shop.
And he bought us a whole lot of wonderful black plastic costumes, and so the sort of very sexiness of Hot Gossip was born. We did our first television show on the Kenny Everett video show.
The Kenny Everett video show.
It was very sexy.
And he labelled us as Kenny Everett's naughty bits.
This one is extra naughty. So eyeballs at the ready. Ear holes, 3, 2, 1, cue.
Walk on the Wild Side was, judging by the sack loads of fan mail we got the next day, was very sexy.
But she never lost her head, even when she was given head. She says, hey, babe, take a walk on the wild side.
The lyrics on that are pretty naughty. There is that, the line, giving head. And it wasn't picked up by the television company, but it was certainly picked up by some viewers who were watching the program and didn't think it was suitable at all.
There was something quite sluttish about Hot Gossip, that they looked a little bit dirty and they were quite bendy, whereas, you know, you're sort of, your other dance troops were all a bit too sort of teeth and eyes, and, you know, Hot Gossip, they do a little bit of a sultry look every now and then, you know.
I was always, always getting told off for smiling. Arlene was, Roy, stop smiling, stop smiling, you're not supposed to smile.
Everything I'd ever seen on television were these people that were sort of smiling as soon as they danced, and it seemed so false and so strange to me.
It was more, hang on, let me get the lips.
Take a walk on the wild side.
I used to do my top lip like that. Hang on.
It was all there. It was all there for you to see. If they wore like tops and stuff like that, they wouldn't wear bras and all the rest of it. They used to jiggle about all over the place. They were fantastic Hot Gossip, actually. They were ahead of the time.
Hot Gossip had a new recruit. Sarah Brightman could sing as well as dance. It opened up a whole new world for the group.
All right. And now some extraterrestrial naughtiness as Sarah Brightman and Hot Gossip lose their hearts to a Starship Trooper.
I lost my heart to a Starship Trooper, flashing lights in outer space.
Fighting for the Federation, hand in hand we'll conquer space.
That is the classic 70s look, that sort of futuristic, everything's going to be silver in the future. Sarah Brightman with her crazy alien eyes.
When I choreographed Starship Trooper, it wasn't that it was done differently to the other stuff, it was just done in such a hurry.
It lacked a lot of the fire and a lot of the energy of other work.
Feel the force, ignore the computers, we're locked on call.
Usually there'd be the look round and it'd be, you know, there'd be a bit of fire in the eyes, and this was a sort of look round and sulk.
I don't think the end product was of Starship Trooper was by any means one of our best. Not at all.
Maybe somebody managed to get some sexual relief from it, but I really don't think it would have turned me on at all. Starfleet Command, requesting your position.